What we have in the last lecture and before that, what we have done is we are trying to characterize the performance of a wireless communication system in a feeding communication channel. So in this regard, what we have done in the last lecture was to look at a multiple antenna system. That is what we said, is we said we are going to consider a system with multiple receive antennas. So I have a system which has basically, I look at this system has multiple receive antennas and we considered a single transmit antenna. And what we also did was we said that the channel gain from transmit antenna to receive antenna 1 is H1. The gain from transmit antenna to receive the channel coefficient from transmit antenna to receive antenna 2 is H2. I have signals that are received that are Y1, Y2. So Y1 equals H1 X plus L1, and also Y2 equals H2X plus L2. So Y1 and Y2 are the signals received at the two receive antennas, and H1 and H2 are the coefficients. So I can write this as a vector. So I have Y bar equals H bar X plus N bar. That is the received, that is my single input multiple. So this is also known as, see, because we have one transmit antenna and two receive antenna, so we have one input. So if you look at this, everyone can look at this, we have one input, that is a single input. And we also have multiple outputs. When you look at this, we also have multiple outputs. Everyone can see that we have single input X, multiple outputs Y1, Y2. If we have more receive antennas, we will have more outputs. So this is a single input, multiple output system. So this system is also known as single input, multiple output. In short, this is also known as a SIMO, or single input multiple output system. Okay, this is a single input multiple output system. Now what we also said is at the single input, the multiple outputs, these multiple outputs, we are going to combine them using weight. So I'm going to perform weighted combination of the outputs. So I'm going to perform at the receiver a weighted combination of at receiver, we perform a weighted combination of outputs. That is, in this case, we perform W1 conjugate Y1 plus W2 conjugate y2 which is equal to w1 conjugate w2 conjugate into y1 y2 which is also equal to w bar Hermitian y bar, right? So at the receiver we are performing a linear combining using weights w1 and w2. So it is written in the form of, it can be written in the form of w bar Hermitian y bar, where w bar is the vector, w1 w2. So this is w bar Hermitian y bar. So now if I write it as w bar Hermitian y bar, what is the w bar Hermitian? So now I have y bar equals h bar x plus n bar. W bar Hermitian y bar equals w bar Hermitian h bar into x plus w bar Hermitian n bar. So we saw that the signal to noise power ratio, this is what we saw last time, the SNR equals expected value of x square times magnitude w bar Hermitian h bar square divided by sigma square norm w bar square, sigma square norm w bar square. And we said that this is basically maximized, this is maximized when W bar is chosen such that W bar equals H bar divided by norm of H bar, that is the optimum vector, that is the optimal vector which maximizes this is W bar equals h bar divided by norm of h bar. And we said in that scenario the SNR, that is the maximum SNR, SNR equals p times norm h bar square divided by sigma square. This is the maximum SNR. This is the maximum SNR of the system. That is P bar, that is P times norm h square, where h is the channel vector, vector of channel coefficients h1, h2 divided by sigma square. Alright. To illustrate this performance of MRC and to illustrate these various aspects of maximum ratio combining, let us do a simple example. So my example is the following thing. Let us do simple MRC example. So the title is, also we called this, remember we introduced a notation, this beamforming vector over here, this beamforming vector, this is also known as a maximal ratio combiner or MRC. This vector, this is known as a maximal ratio combiner or MRC, right? And this is also, remember, this is a matched filter. This is a matched filter because the weighting vector W is basically equal to the channel vector h. So the weighting vector w is matched to the channel vector h. Can everyone can see that? Also the weighting vector w match to the channel vector. The weighting vector w bar is matched to the channel vector h bar. So in that sense it is also a matched filter, but it is matching across the antennas, therefore it is a spatially matched filter. Spatial denotes the antennas which are array in space. So this is a spatially matched filter. This is a spatially matched filter. Alright, so this is a spatially matched filter. So let us go to our example. In our example, let us consider a maximal ratio combining example. And here I will ask questions and I will see how well the students have understood it, so that you will get an chance to test your understanding. Let us describe a MIMO communication, a single input with two receive antennas, one transmit antenna. So I am considering two RX antennas, one transmit antenna, two receive antennas, one transmit antenna. So my system model is given as follows. I have y1, y2 equal to y1, y2 equal to half plus half j R minus this is my single input multiple output system model. This is my single input multiple output system model. So this is my two receive antenna, one transmit antenna system model, right? Okay, everyone can see that? All of you students can see this system model. Now my question is, in this system model, what is the value of h1 equal to, what is the value of h2 equal to? So let us first start with a very simple question. What is h1, what is h2? Can someone tell me what is H1, what is H2? Is the question clear? What are the channel coefficients H1 and H2 in this system? That is where we are considering. Basically, we have two receive antennas. And one transmit antenna. What are the values of H1 and H2? Can someone reply reply on the chat window? Can someone give me the answer? What are the channel coefficients H1 and H2 in this system? Alright, I am getting the answer from PSGCT. H1 is equal to half plus half j, correct? How about H2? What is H2? H2 is equal to KNMU also is giving the answer. H1 is equal to half plus half j, H2 is equal to half minus half j. That is exactly correct. This is a simple question. J which is basically I'm just testing your knowledge of the system model. This here, this coefficient, this is H1, this coefficient here, this is H2. So H1 is equal to half plus half A, H2 is equal to half minus half A. So H1 is equal to half plus half J, H2 is equal to half minus half J. Okay. Now, what is the MRC combining vector? What is the MRC combining vector? So the second question is, what is the MRC combining vector W bar? Can someone answer this question? What is the MRC combining vector W bar? Now, of course, W bar, we have written the expression for W bar. Can someone first tell me what is the expression for W bar, and then we will calculate what is the MRC combining vector W bar. What is the MRC combining vector W bar? You can look at this expression. MRC combining vector is H bar divided by norm H bar. Very good, very good. I'm getting the answer from KNMU. I hope everyone is able to follow. MRC combining vector W bar equals, so we have W bar equals H bar divided by norm H bar. My question is, what is norm H bar? Now, can someone tell me what is norm H bar? In this scenario, what is norm H bar? Very good. I'm getting some answers. Very good. Can someone tell me what is norm H bar? What is norm H bar? You can see this vector here. This vector here, this is actually the vector H bar, right? This is the channel coefficient vector, vector H1, H2, where H1 equals half plus half J, H2 equals half minus half J. This is the channel vector. This is the channel vector, H1 bar plus H2 bar. Can someone tell me what is norm H bar? Can any college tell me what is norm H bar? What is the norm? What is the definition of a norm of a vector? Can someone tell me this? Norm of a vector. Any college, any student, can someone tell me what is the norm of the vector? Norm H. Norm of H bar. What is norm of, what is norm of H norm of H bar. Okay, I'm getting the correct answer. GCT has given me the correct answer, but I want some more students to respond. So norm of h bar, remember norm of h bar is square root of magnitude h1 square plus magnitude h2 square. Can now someone, can you compute that? MIT, it's not square root of half. PSGCT, I'm asking the norm. Norm has to be a, I'm asking only norm of h bar. I'm not asking what is w bar. I'm asking what is norm h bar. Norm h bar, that is correct. That is square root of magnitude h1 square plus magnitude h2 square. You can see norm h bar, everyone, I hope you can see norm h bar equals square root of magnitude h1 square plus magnitude h2 square, which is square root of, now magnitude h1 square is half plus half, right? Because h1 is 1 over square root of 2 minus or plus 1 over square root of 2 j. So magnitude h1 square is magnitude real part square plus magnitude imaginary part square, that is half plus half. Similarly, magnitude h2 square is half plus half, which is equal to basically 2, so this is square root of 2. It is not 1 over root 2 KNMU, norm h bar is equal to square root of 2. W bar, now can someone tell me what is W bar? W bar equals h bar divided by norm h bar, which is equal to h bar divided by square root of 2. Therefore, now can someone tell me what is the MRC combining vector? What is the MRC vector W bar? What is the MRC vector W bar? Can someone tell me what is the MRC vector W? What is the MRC vector W? MRC vector W bar equals H bar divided by square root of 2. This is equal to, can someone tell me what is the MRC vector? MRC vector W bar is equal to H bar divided by square root of 2. What is that vector? That is what I am asking. The question is, what is that vector? H bar divided by square root of 2. What is that vector? H bar divided by square root of 2, what is the vector? It is a vector, it is not a scalar. Everyone is giving me some scalar answer. W bar equals H bar divided by square root of 2, what is the vector? If I divide a vector by square root of 2, I will get another vector. That is what I am asking. What is the vector that I am getting? What is the vector W bar? W bar equals h bar divided by square root of 2. What is the vector h bar? What is the vector w bar? I'm sorry. What is the vector w bar? What is the vector W bar? Can someone tell me what is the vector W bar? Take a look at this. H bar we already know. H bar is this vector. We know norm H. Norm H is square root of 2. I'm asking what is the vector W bar? W bar is equal to H bar divided by square root of 2. What is that W bar? Can someone give me the expression? I'm getting some answer from KNMU that is not correct. It is not 1 by 2 root 2. Can someone try to give me the answer? It is not 1 by 2 root 2. Can someone else try? What is the vector H bar? Can someone tell me what is the vector H bar? Can any student respond? What is the vector? What is the vector H bar divided by square root of 2? That is W bar. No, it is not 1 by 2 square root of 2. Can someone please check correctly what is the vector? Oh, okay. I think I have given, okay, I think what I'm doing is, okay, I think I have made a slight mistake. Okay, I think what people are saying is probably correct. Okay, so let me just go back, let me correct my answer a little bit. Looks like I'm looking at half plus half j and half minus half j. So my answer is slightly incorrect because magnitude h1 square is half square, right? It has to be, so this is slightly, the error lies here. Actually it is half square, 1 by 4 plus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 4 because I am saying h1 is equal to half plus half j, h2 is equal to half minus half j. So magnitude h1 square is equal to 1 by 4 plus 1 by 4, magnitude h2 square is 1 by 4 plus 1 by square. So this is going to be actually 1. Actually this is slightly wrong. This is going to be 1. This is also 1. I'm sorry, I'm correcting myself. I'm sorry for this mistake. W bar is equal to H bar divided by 1, which is H bar itself. So this is basically H bar itself, which is nothing but half plus half J, half minus half plus half j, half minus half plus half j, half minus half j. Is everyone able to understand that? Is everyone able to follow? Any questions? Therefore, W bar is equal to H bar divided by 1. Further, we have at the receiver, we will process as W1 conjugate y1 plus w2 conjugate y2, which is basically equal to w1 conjugate is half minus half j into y1 plus half j into y2. So this is the weighted combination at the receiver. So this is the what is this This is the weighted combination at the receiver. So what is this? This is the weighted combination at the receiver. Now can someone tell me what is the SNR at the receiver corresponding to the this weighted combination? If the transmit power is P, noise power is sigma square, what is the SNR at the receiver? What is the SNR at the What is the SNR at the receiver? Can someone think about this? SNR equals, what is the SNR at the receiver? What is the SNR at the receiver corresponding to this thing? I'm getting the correct answer from PSG. SNR at the receiver is, we have already said SNR at the receiver is E over sigma square divided by, I'm also getting the answer from KNMU, divided to norm h bar square. But we already see this norm h bar square equals 1, which means SNR at the receiver is equal to E over sigma square. This is the SNR at the receiver. SNR at the receiver is P over sigma square. SNR at the receiver is P over sigma square. Can everyone follow this? SNR at the receiver is P over sigma square. Is everyone able to follow? All the students, are you able to follow what we are doing so far? We are doing, what we have done so far is we have considered maximum ratio combining, that is MRC. We have considered maximum ratio combining for a single input multiple output system. We have considered a maximum ratio combining system. We have considered a maximum ratio combining system. For this maximum ratio combining system, we have derived the SNR. Now let us go to the bit error analysis. Let us go to the bit error rate. We have said SNR is equal to E by sigma square norm h bar square is equal to P by sigma square square root of, or P by sigma square root of, or not square root of, P by sigma square times magnitude h1 square plus magnitude h2 square for this 2 receive antenna system. Now magnitude H1 square, let us call denote magnitude H1 square G1 and magnitude H2 square equals G2. Therefore SNR is equal to P by sigma square into E1 plus E G1 plus G2. Therefore SNR is equal to P by sigma square into G1 plus G2. What is the instantaneous bit error rate? That is, given SNR P over sigma square into G1 plus G2, what is the instantaneous bit error rate? That is, what is the current bit error rate of the system? What is the current bit error rate? I am not asking about the average bit error rate. Given this SNR, what is the current bit error rate? What is the current bit error rate of the system? Can someone tell me what is the current bit error rate of the system? Q square root of SNR. Very good. So Q square root of SNR, that is the current bit error rate, that is Q of square root of E over sigma square times G1 plus G2. So current bit error rate, current or instantaneous bit error rate is Q of square root of E by sigma square into G1 plus G2. Current bit error rate as a function of the channel gains is Q of square root of SNR at the receiver, that is signal to noise power ratio at the receiver. And signal to noise power ratio at the receiver is P over sigma square times G1 plus G2, where G1 is equal to magnitude H1 square, G2 is equal to magnitude H2 square. Therefore, the signal to noise power ratio at the receiver is Q of square root of P over sigma square times G1 plus G2. We all did an approximation for the Q function earlier. Does anyone remember the approximation for the Q function from our previous lectures? We said Q of X is approximately equal to, in fact it is less than or equal to, what is the approximation we used for the Q function? Does anyone remember what is the approximation that we used for the Q function? What is the approximation that we used for the Q function? What is the approximation that we used for the Q function? Q of X is approximately equal to half e to the power of GCT. I am getting the correct answer. Very good. It's half e to the power of minus half X square. Correct. Very good. It's half e to the power of, very good, very good. Half e to the power of minus half X square. Therefore, my bit error rate Q of square root of P over sigma square, G1 TKM college, I'm also getting the correct answer. Very good, very good. So Q of square root of P over sigma square G1 plus G2 is approximately half e power minus half P over sigma square times G1 plus G2. Everyone accepts that? Since Q of X is approximately half e to the power of minus half X square, Q of square root of P over sigma square G1 plus G2 is approximately half e to the power of minus half P over sigma square times G1 plus G2. Everyone can see that? It is half e to the power of minus half P over sigma square G1 plus G2. Can everyone can see that? Now, in order to compute the average bit error rate, what should I do? What should I do in order to compute the average bit error rate? This is the instantaneous bit error rate. This is a function of the channel gains G1 and G2. In order to compute the average bit error rate, what should I do? Is the question clear to everyone, students and teachers? In order to compute the average bit error rate, what should I do? I'm not asking for the answer. I'm simply saying, what should I, what is the next step I should do in order to UIUT, very good, I'm getting the answer. Integrate the function, correct. Integrate what function? Integrate over what? Is the answer is correct. I have to integrate it. Integrate it over what? Very good. Can you just tell me integrate over what? K
ANMU also integrate, very good, integrate over what? But integration, integrate over what? Integrate over the PDF, good. PSGCT is also replying, integrate over the PDF, very good. Integrate over the PDF of what? Over the PDF of 0 to infinity, minus infinity to infinity. No, I am not asking for the range. What is the integration variable? That is what I am asking. PDF of G1 and G2. Very good, very good, very good. I am getting the correct answer. Very good. PSGCT, I am getting the correct answer. I have to integrate over the PDF of G1 and G2 because G1 and G2 are the gains of the channel. I have to integrate over the PDF of G1 and G2 because these are random variables. Integrate over PDF of because G1 and G2 are the channel gains. These are the random variables. These are random variables. Therefore, I have to integrate over the PDF of G1 and G2. Very good. Now, the PDF of G is e to the power of minus G. That is what we have seen, right? Therefore, the PDF of G1 is e to the power of minus G1 f of G1 that is, or let me call this as f of G1. So PDF of random variable G1 is f of G1. PDF of random variable G2 is f of G2. F of G2 is e to the power of minus G2. My question to all of you now is, what is the joint PDF? What is the joint PDF? What is the joint PDF F of G1 comma G2, what is the joint PDF? Can someone tell me what is the joint PDF F of G1 comma G2 of these two channel gains G1, G2? What is the joint PDF of these two channel gains F of G1 comma G2? What is the joint PDF of the two channel gains G1 and G2? That is f of G1 comma G2. What is the joint PDF? That is what I am asking. Can someone answer this question? What is the joint PDF f of G1 comma PSGCT? I am getting the answer, but it's not the correct answer. Would you like to correct your answer? What is the joint PDF? First, you have to think a little bit. How can I get the joint PDF? E to the power of minus G1 plus G2. Correct. Why is this e to the power of minus G1 plus G2? Can someone tell me why is the joint PDF? What is the assumption? And how am I obtaining? No, KNMU, it is not e to the power of minus G1 plus e to the power of minus G2. It is e to the power of minus G1 plus G2. Can someone tell me why is e to the power of minus G1 plus G2? PSGCT has the correct answer. Why is it? Can you explain to me how you are able to get e to the power of minus G1 plus G2? Can you tell me, PSGCT, how are you able to get? G1 and G2 are VCAP also correct. That is the multiplication. G1 and G2, the correct answer is G1 and G2 are independent. Correct. We are assuming the channel gains are independent random variables. If the channel gains are independent, then the probability density is the multiplication of the two probability densities. Therefore, f of g1 g2 is equal to f of g1 into f of g2, that is e to the power of minus g1 into e to the power of minus g2 equals e to the power of minus g1 plus g2. Therefore, in order to average this, what I have to do? I have to multiply this probability density. Everyone look at this. Everyone please look at this, because I am going to do something analytically rigorous. So please follow this thing carefully. I have to multiply this bit error rate with this probability density, and I have to integrate from 0 to infinity. So let us do that now. I have to basically multiply e to the power of minus p by 2 sigma square g1 plus g2 into e to the power of minus g1 plus g2 into dg1 into dg2, and both these random variables I have to integrate from 0 to infinity. That is g1 gain g1 from 0 to infinity, gain g2 from 0 to infinity. Now look at this. Now everyone look at this. I can write this as e to the power of minus g1 into p over 2 sigma square e to the power of into e to the power of minus g2 p over 2 sigma square into e to the power of minus g1 into e to the power of minus g2 dg1 dg2 integral 0 to infinity 0 to infinity. Now collecting the terms of g1, collecting the terms of g1, this is e to the power of minus g1 into 1 plus p over 2 sigma square into e to the power of minus g2 1 plus p over 2 sigma square into dg1 dg2. Now can everyone see this is product of two integrals? One is a function of g1, one is a function of g2. Therefore it will split into two separate integrals, because this is the product of two integrals. This is product of two integrals. One depends only on g1, one depends only on g2. Therefore this is a separable function. Everyone can see that this is a separable function. This is a product of g function of g1. This depends only on g1. This depends only on g2. Therefore this integral is equal to 0 to infinity e power minus g1 into 1 plus p over 2 sigma square dg1 integral 0 to infinity e to the power of minus g2 1 plus p over 2 sigma square dg2. Now my question to you is, all the students and faculty members and teachers who are attending courses, what is the value of this integral? Can someone tell me what is the value of this integral? Integral 0 to, look at this, this is the form of integral 0 to infinity e to the power of minus ax dx, right? What is the value of this integral? Can someone answer that question quick, as we, because it is already 8:55. Can someone answer that question? E to the power of UIET, very good, I'm getting the answer. 1 by 1 over p plus sigma square, p 1 by 1 over p 1 plus p by 2 sigma square, correct, very good. This integral is nothing but 1 over 1 plus p divided by 2 sigma square. How about this integral? Can someone tell me how about this integral? This integral is also exactly 1 over 1 plus p by, very good, I'm getting the correct answer, and therefore this is nothing but the product of these two, which is equal to 1 over 1 plus p by 2 sigma square whole square. Therefore, the bit error rate of this system with two receive antennas is 1 over 1 plus p by 2 sigma square whole square. Very good, all of you, very good performance. I'm asking several questions, I'm getting answers from everyone. Bit error rate with two antennas, with two receive antennas, bit error rate with two receive antennas is equal to 1 over 1 plus p over 2 sigma square whole square. Very good. Everyone, I am getting the correct answer. Several people have answered the bit error rate with two receive antennas, that is 1 over 1 plus p by 2 sigma square whole square. And remember, this is the average bit error rate, because we have averaged over the, this is the average bit error rate, because we have averaged over channel gains, yes, correct. Sorry, UI LNMIT is pointing out I missed a factor of half. That is correct. Sorry, LNMIT. Yes, you're correct. You're absolutely correct. I forgot the factor of half. Sorry, because in QX, there is a factor of half. Thank you, LNMIT, for pointing out. So everywhere here, there has to be a factor of half. Thank you very much for pointing it out. Yeah, I have missed the factor of half. Very good. I'm glad everyone is paying attention. Very good. I missed the factor of half. I'm very sorry. I missed the factor of half. Yes, the factor of half is coming from this part. Remember, the factor of half is coming from here. I forgot to write this factor of half. Very good, LNMIT. Very good. I forgot to write the factor of half. The factor of half has to be there, so it is half 1 over 1 plus p over 2 sigma square whole square. So the bit error rate is half times 1 over 1 plus p by 2 sigma square whole square. Very good. This is the average bit error rate for a single input multiple output system with two receive antennas, where the transmitted power is p, the noise power is sigma square. Very good, all of you. I'm glad you are able to, several people are answering questions, several people are also able to, you know, complete the steps when I'm illustrating them. I'm very happy. So some of you are able to, looks like many of you are able to understand this. All right, very good, keep up the interest. And if you have any questions, unfortunately, again, every time we are running out of time, what I will do is, next time I will dedicate some time exclusively to taking questions and answers, because I'm getting a feeling that I'm not able to interact with many people, because every time what is happening is, towards the end of the lecture, we are running out of time. So I'm not getting enough time to take the questions. Next time what I will do is, I will set apart 5 to 10 minutes exclusively to take questions, and to answer the questions of both students, faculty members, graduate, undergraduate students who are attending this. I hope everything is clear. I will again repeat the salient points next time if it's not clear. But in the meantime, please go through these lecture notes. The notes will be available. Please go through these lecture notes. And if you have any questions, write them down. We will discuss them next time. All right. Thank you, everyone. Thank you.